Central is gravy.
Yeah, Steve, you're trying to get at your children. No way you could ever produce a record. So silly.
No, right.
I don't think it's true. I mean, if you take a packing up group and then go to 12, so.
What am I talking
about? Well, you're talking about producing works of art, I mean, or whatever, or big film records. I mean, that's only about 5.5% of the market. There's plenty of other
going on. No, we're not talking about that at all. We're talking about a record producer as somebody who is in charge of a recording session. Right? And in order to be in charge of a recording session, you need to have a kind of minimum, well, not minimal, you need to have a fairly extensive knowledge of what the equipment's about, and what music is about, and what rock and roll's about. Well, Steve knows what rock and roll's about, he's got no idea what the equipment's about, and he's got very little idea in terms of kind of technicalities, what the music's about. But he knows what he likes.
Plenty of people have produced records on that basis.
On a very successful record.
Right. In the finished article, the only thing that is important is whether it moves you or not. There's nothing else as important at all.
I can't get up with some of those records on the skill by the
I'm going to play that record. Because I've seen
the wrong business. Oh, that was a bad cut. That's got nothing to do with production. The album. That was a bad cut. And if you listen to the second string of Pressings, you'll find that sibilance isn't there. Well, if you can still hear sibilance on the second string of Pressings, you've got an extremely overactive imagination. Because there isn't any.
We have some pretty good arguments from time to time, yes.
Yeah, you might see that.
Yeah, we're pretty durable. We do have in fighting. But you mean without actually exploding? We share the same sense of humour to some extent. We lust after money to some extent. And we have a lot of interest in what we're doing together. We can still combine our interests. I think that's really when the thing breaks down, is when maybe just one person finds that what he's doing doesn't interest him, or you know, he feels that he could do something better by himself. We did have some very difficult times about a few years ago. We seem to have managed to avoid the things that really get people too touchy these days.
Where things go, I'd say.
Yeah.
You mentioned lust for money to be one of the main drivers.
Only jokingly, naturally, for less money-minded people would be hard to find.